Hello, it's Sara, and I am still working on pins and ornaments for Christmas racks. And I just want to show you what I've been up to. I actually made some gingerbread pins, and I made some more snowflakes, but I made them in a pin. So I'll show you what I did. I got these at Michael's the other day. This was in their Christmas section. I think it was in a on an end cap with just all Christmas stickers and Christmas stuff, and it's wood stickers, and these are little snowflakes. I think there were 12, and these are smaller than these. So I used the bigger ones, and I made at least 6 of these little pins, and I'll show you. I also got these, and I'm down to, there were 22 pieces in here. This is Art Minds discs, and they're 1.5 inch round discs, and I don't know what made me think to get them, but I did. And because I knew it was close to the size of the little face on here, you know, so I ended up putting each one of the discs on top of one of the snowflakes. And this one's too small. I just don't think it looks right. I think you could do it. I might end up doing it, but I have a lot of snowflakes and I wanted to make some gingerbread, so I'll show you them. So these are just put aside for now, the extra snowflakes, but I have a bunch. I have like six of these. They all had white on one side, but some of them are red on the back. And so I've made, how many did I make of these? I think 6. So there's one around here somewhere that I can't see, but I think they turned out super cute. So these are all pins. So I've glued my pins on the back, and then I have the snowflakes. Here it is. Oh no, that's not, it's around here somewhere drying, I'm sure, because I put pins on everything and I had to. My desk is just kind of filled with a million things. So here's the ornaments that I did. So this will be the ornament, and this is the pin. And I debated putting a little ribbon on here, like I have this red ribbon, but I just didn't think it needed it. Or even in his hair or something, because I didn't put the little sprig of the leaf on there. Oh, here it is. Here's the other one. So I have 6 of these. Love them. And I was even thinking I could drill, which I'm not sure. I don't think I want to risk it now because I could maybe try it on one of the little ones, drilling with my Dremel, and I could put a charm, because this is what I did with the little gingerbreads. So I just used the disc itself and did the gingerbread guy, and I put a little, let me show you this one, because I put bows on 4 of them, and I kind of liked it, but I'm not sure that I love it, and I'm not sure that I'll do it on all of them, but because I hung a charm down bottom too, so that has a snowflake. So this is what it looks like here. This is one with this bow, and this is without. So I think you could do it either way. These are so simple, so I'm going to do one of these with you guys today. And I put my pin on the back, and I put a little charm. So these both have the snowflake. And for the most part, I put, because I have 6 more to do with these. Well, 7 counting the one I'm going to do right now. So I just put bows on all of them of this batch. But I might not put bows on the other batch, because I kind of just wanted to cover, or I tried tying a ribbon around the like findings. And so, anywho. All right, let's get moving on this. So all I've done to this so far is painted it with raw sienna. Let's see, yeah, raw sienna. So front and back, I have a bunch more ready to go over here, but this is the one that's for the tutorial. And then after that, I took the gold paint, just like I did on the other ones, and just rubbed it around the edge. And so we're ready to go. You're also gonna need a pin, a little eye pin as well, a jump ring, and a charm. So I'm going to put a candy cane on him, and I'll do that at the end. All right, let's paint. So I'm going to use burnt umber, and this is very simple design. And I'm going to float. I'm going to use my floating technique. So I'm grabbing my big angle brush and get some burnt umber on here. It's very similar to the snowflake, just about the same. So let me make sure I'm in the shot. I have his little face on there, and I'm just going to hold it with the eyes kind of facing up, and I'm going to slide some burnt umber around this whole side over here. And that's it. He didn't get highlighted at all. So it's basically, you know, just a little shading. I'm going to go back a couple times and do that. What else? See, I could be doing a couple right now. I'm just going to sand very gently. Because if you sand your wood, even though it makes it look, once you varnish it, it'll be great. But then your paint just slides across there so easily when you've sanded the surface. So I'll do a couple more. Why not? Because I just have to wait for that float to dry before I, because I don't want to put my brush in it and pull it off. So this one is so simple. I love, because I tried the dip dot eyes and I really like them on here. And we're going to do them last, of course, because you can really, dip dots are tricky because you really have to wait for them to dry before you, because you can stick your hand in it. I've done it so many times. They take a little longer to dry than if you painted the circles. So I'm just darkening that up real nice. So that's my second float on there. Just let it dry. I'm going to put a little coat. I don't know what color she has down here. It's called, where the heck is it? Dragon fruit for the nose. I didn't have any, and so I'm using coral. It's just a pinkish color. Like, it's kind of like a skin tone color, and I'm just going to use that. I think it looked cute on here, see? You know, it could be a piece of candy. You can make it red. You can make it any color you want. Oops, a little too much paint. So let's put a nose on here so you guys kind of can see. And you can make it small or big. All my noses were different shapes on these guys. Look, he's kind of oval. He's got like an oval nose. And so, oops. See, circles grow. They're so, I'm going to try and take it off. Circles always grow on me. Oh, sorry. I like to make mistakes so you guys see. I'm not perfect. I definitely make mistakes. Sorry, I'm putting my head in. There's a little glare. I keep making it bigger. All right, stop. I'm leaving it there. All right, and then we'll let that dry, but we're going to put a little float above the eye like we did on the snowflake too. See how they're very similar? It's the same design basically, but it just has a different nose. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take the burnt umber and I'm going to float it right under the eyes with the color facing down. So I'm going to go here over the nose, around and down there. I see my eyes, but you guys probably can't. I think that's dark enough. I don't want it to be too dark. And then before we do anything else, we're going to scrub some cheeks on, but I want to make sure that's dry. But it's super simple. I mean, we're basically done. See, I don't have a real face on there to Matt and Maya are playing Jurassic World in the other room. But I'm going to scrub on some cheeks, and I have a dry brush. This is by Debbie Cole. And it has some pink on it already. And she uses this Napa Red, which is a really deep, dark red. And we're going to use that to shade our nose with. But for the... So when you dry brush, you take a little bit of paint on the brush. I'm a little zoomed in too close. Hold on. There we go. It's too much paint. And you pounce it into the bristles. Then you take a dry, paper towel. And pounce it and try to take off some of the paint. Then you go to your piece and just in a circular motion, gently, and you want to build the color. You don't want it to go on right away. So it's gently, gently, gently. Just let the bristles do the work. And I'm going to put a cheek over here. So two cheeks for this guy. The snowman only got one. See? I love him. He's so handsome. So cheek there, cheek there. I'm just going to set my brush aside because I'll use it again because it has that same color. I'm going to put a little more of the nose color on. And then we'll float. Basically, he's pretty much done. I want to show you how to put the charm on, though. This is something I'd like to share with you. So before, actually, I just did the nose, too. I have a little eye pin, a gold eye pin. It has an eye on one end. I have this tool here. This is I call it an awl, and, you know, it is a type of awl, I guess. It's just a pointy. I know there's a tool, for brads, I think. I don't know. Or it could be a piercing tool. A piercing tool would work. So all I'm going to do, when I did the first ones, I kind of did crack the wood. So you don't want to go too deep. I got a little paint on here that I didn't want. You just want to do it about, I don't know, is that an eighth of an inch? Really shallow. So I'm going to take it and face it to the top and put it and just go in the middle of the side. This is a thick disc, and just put some pressure and twist. So it's not hard, just gently pressure and twist. And if you hear it crack, stop, because you don't need it to be too deep. Let's see how deep we are. So that's how deep it went. And that's all you need. Now you want to cut this eye pin to be the same depth. And I actually go a little smaller, so be careful. Close your eyes and clip it, and then you're going to hold it with pliers. Take some glossy accents. I have a new bottle. Put it on the little metal piece that you're going to stick into the wood, and then just kind of wipe the glue. Trying to find the hole, there it is, and just press and twist it into the hole until it's flush. And that isn't going anywhere. Now these eye pins, I wish I could tell you the size and all that, the weight or the whatever, but I did just buy these, and I think they're the same thing. These are by Bead Landing. But they seem to be the same, what would you call it, like gauge? So it doesn't even give a gauge. Nickel free, it says. So that's what I would suggest, okay? And then so now we have this little place down here where we can hang. I'm just going to do it now because it doesn't really matter. This little charm. So you open up a jump ring, put it on, put the charm on, and close it up. So now you have a little charm on there. We're going to add, you know what, I'm going to float one more time where the eyes go, just because I like dark floats. And I mean, because it gives that illusion that he has a little nose, a little snout almost, right? It just adds dimension, and I really like that. So I'm going to put a little more, plus we pounced over it with the cheeks, so it might have gotten a little cloudy. I like it better like that. So now we need to get the black out and do some eyes and some eyebrows and a mouth. And for the mouth, it's just a simple little, you can do whatever you want, but I like the way she kind of just did a little half a mouth almost, right? Isn't that cute? So I'm gonna get my black on my brush and just make a little, am I in the shot? A little smiley and then a little boop. So it's like half a mouth. Isn't that cute? And then he has little eyebrows. I like to, see, you can't see where his eyes are because I'm gonna use a dip dot in a minute. Okay. I gotta do them last because I will put my finger in it. Sorry about that. We gotta shade our nose, so I'm gonna use that red that we used for the cheeks. And down the bottom or towards the left, just like you did on the face, so right there. And we'll highlight the tip of it in a minute. The last thing I'm gonna do is a little light buttermilk icing line around the outside. And then after it's all varnished and everything, I actually did it with liquid pearls, dimensional pearlescent paint by Ranger. And I love how it turned out. It just gave it that extra dimensional, and it is dimensional. It sticks out a little bit. So, okay. And so to do that, I just took some light buttermilk, get it moving so it's nice and wet and flows off your brush like ink, and just go around the edge, a little swervy line. And then when it's varnished and everything, I'm gonna go right over this line with the perfect pearls, or the, what's it called, liquid pearls. I always call liquid pearls perfect pearls. Cute, right? It looks like his eyes are closed right now. That even looks cute. But I am gonna do dip dots. Then I'll come back and I want to just show you the liquid pearls and then I'll be done. So you just take a fresh pile of black and I'm going to dip dot and dip dot. But see how clean and round they turn out and shiny? But it just takes a minute for that to dry. We can highlight though. There is little cheek highlight and a little nose highlight with the light buttermilk. I'm just going to take a tiny bit and put a little there. And then I like to use my stylus for dip dots on the little cheeks. Gotta find it. My desk is covered, you guys. Covered with goodness. Can't find it. I'm gonna use this one. This is a much bigger stylus, but I'll just tap it off first. And it'll be fine. Cute, right? So that's it. I'm gonna come back and I want to show you that dimensional paint when those eyes are dry. All right, I'll be right back. All right, I'm assembly lining some more, but this has been, it dried, the eyes dried, and I put a little varnish on top of some of my sparkle varnish, which I looked again today. This is Folk Art Sparkle Varnish by Plaid. I'm gonna Google it and see if it exists, because I've had this, I think I'm, let me see how much I have. Yeah, it's getting really down to the bottom, but this is awesome stuff for Christmas decoration. So let me zoom in. And I just wanted to show you that this Ranger Liquid Pearls is really good, because some of them come out really thick. And this one actually comes out nice and thin. And you just have to squeeze it as you move so that it leaves kind of a, what would I say, a uniform squiggle. But some of them, like, I went a little thick and I pushed down, and you know, it doesn't have to be perfect. It's icing. It's when you ice your cookie. So just have fun. This is actually the best one I've done. All the other ones look way thicker. I think the more you do it, the better you get. You get a knack for it. Well, as I say that, I kind of made a thick part. You know what? You can probably take it off. Yep. So I could take it off and try again. Just try to make that connection a little thinner. Ta-da! It's a little big up there. See, but see, like, if you look at the rest of them, there's like thick, thin. So what do you think? Do you like the bow or not the bow? So here's no bow, bow, no bow, bow. I think they're good either way. I don't know. I think it's either way. All right, you guys. Have fun. Happy holidays. Bye.